Reflection of light.
Consider a reflecting surface. A ray of light strikes on the surface and reflects in this direction. This ray is called incident ray, and this ray is called reflected ray. And the point is called point of incidence. And this is the normal. The angle between incident ray and normal is called angle of incidence. And the angle between normal and reflected ray is called angle of reflection. The first law of reflection is that the angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. And the second law of reflection, the incident ray, the normal and the reflected ray at the point of incidence all lies in same plane. This is the reflecting surface and this is the grain laser light. This is the incident ray and this is the reflected ray, and the point is called the point of incidence. Now this is the normal. This is the normal. The angle between the incident ray and the normal is called the angle of incidence, and the angle between the reflected ray and the normal is called the angle of reflection. The first law is that the angle of incidence and the angle of reflection are equal. And the second law is the incident ray and the reflected ray and the normal at the point of incidence all lies in one plane. This plane, if you move these directions, then the plane even same. This is not this the reflected plane, this is the plane. Reflection of light by spherical mirrors. First for concave mirror. And this is the principal axis. This point is the pole. Let a parallel ray of light strike on the surface and reflect back in this direction. The point is called the focus or focal point. The distance between the focus F and pole P is called the focal length. Then for convex mirror, this is the principal axis. This point is called the pole. Let a ray of light, parallel ray of light, strike on the surface and reflect in this direction. And it appears to meet at the point. And this point is called focus or focal point, capital F. And the distance between pole and focus is called focal length. This is the parallel ray of light and this is the concave mirror, and the ray of light is reflect back, and the point of intersection, this point is called as the focus, and the distance between the focus and the pole, here is the pole, is called the focal length. These are the parallel ray of light and this is the convex mirror. The ray after strike, they reflect back in this direction. If we draw the path, after remove this, if you join, it appears to like meet at the point. This point is called the focus. And the distance between the pole and the focus is called the focal length.
Refraction of light.
Consider two medium. This is medium 1. This is medium 2. This is the refracting surface. Let a ray of light strike on the surface and move in this direction. And this is the incident ray and this is the refracted ray. And this point is the point of incidence. This is the normal. The angle between incident ray and normal is called angle of incidence. and the angle between refracted ray and normal is called angle of refraction. Then law of refraction. The first law is the incident ray, refracted ray and normal at the point of incidence all lies in the same plane, this plane, just like whiteboard, not this plane. The second law, the sin I by sin r is equal to mu 2 by mu 1 is equal to constant, where mu 2 is the refractive index of the second medium, mu 1 is the refractive index of the first medium. This is also called as Snell's law.
Refraction of light.
It is a glass slab. The glass is a denser medium. Outside it is a rarer medium. Now this is the incident ray. This is the refracted ray. The angle between the normal, here is the normal. Normal and incident ray is the angle of incident. And the angle between the normal and the this refracted ray is called angle of refraction. When a ray is traveled from the rarer medium to denser medium, it moves towards the normal.
Refraction of light by spherical lens.
First for convex lens. And this is the optical center O. Let a parallel ray of light passing through the lens and moving in this direction. And the point is called the focus or focal point. The distance between the optical center and the focus is called the focal length. Then for concave lens, this is the principal axis and the point is called the optical center. Let a parallel ray of light passing through and bend in the directions, and it appears like to meet at the point. This point is called the focus or focal point. And the distance between the focus and the optical center is called focal length, small f. These are the parallel ray of light. It is a convex lens. If we place, then the rays of light are meet at the point, and this point is called the focus or focal point. And the distance between the focus and the optical center is called the focal length. These are the parallel ray of light. It is a concave lens. If you place, then the ray of light are diverge in this direction. It is appears to like meet in the opposite directions, means in this directions. So the focus is lies on the side. These are two parallel ray of light. When we place a convex lens, it is meet at the point, and this point is called the focus. These are two parallel ray of light. When we place a concave lens, the rear divergent direction, it appears to meet in the opposite direction. Here is the focus or focal point.
Total internal reflection, TIR.
Let us consider two medium. This is the rarer medium and this is the denser medium. It may be air, it may be water. The ray of light is moving from denser medium to rarer medium. In the first case, this is the incident ray and the angle is the angle of incident and this is the angle of refraction. In the second case, the angle of incident is greater from the first case. In this case, the angle of refraction is 90 degree and the angle of incident is called the critical angle. In the third case, the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle. In this situation, the ray will come back to the same medium. This phenomenon is called as the total internal reflection or TIR.
The bowl contains half of water and the above water surface is the air.
The water is the denser medium, the air is the rarer medium. Now see, a ray of light inside the water return to the same medium, means inside the water, it is the phenomenon of total internal reflection.
This is a glass slab and it is a denser medium, and outside it is a thinner medium. It is the incident ray. When a ray is passing through it, now see the ray is back in the same medium, and this is the total internal reflection. This is the prism. This is the incident ray, and the ray which is inside the prism is called the refracted ray, and this ray is called the emergent ray. The angle between the emergent ray and the incident ray, the direction of incidence, is called the angle of deviation. Inside the glass there is a water. This is the incident ray. Now see the ray is bent to the same medium, reflect back in the same medium. That means the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle. It is the phenomenon is called the total internal reflection.